What's going on, everybody? Gem Mint here, back again with another statue unboxing and review. And as you can see, we have the Spider-Man Noir premium format by Sideshow. I got a chance to see this piece in person at Sideshow Con last year, 2023. And even though I'm not the biggest fan of Spider-Man Noir, I am a Spider-Man guy, and this piece was really impressive. Sculpted by Daniel Bell and George Villar. We're gonna get into the unboxing, but some of you may be asking, who is Spider-Man Noir? Well, if you haven't seen Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, he is from the comics, not the Marvel 616, but he's from Earth 90214. It's also known as Earth-Noir, and it's set in the time during the Great Depression in New York City. So Peter Parker becomes Spider-Man via the Spider Idol. Norman Osborn swiped this piece as it was in transit to the Metropolitan Museum of Art. When it fell, it crashed open and a swarm of spiders came out. Not only did they take out one of Norman's henchmen, but one of the spiders bit Peter Parker, giving him godlike spider powers. Not only was this character part of a theatrical movie, like I mentioned before, but there's also a live-action television show in the works for Amazon Prime. So the character is getting more popular by the moment. With that history lesson out of the way, let's go ahead and do the unboxing, the assembly, and then the review. All right, guys, styrofoam box, two straps, no tape on this one. Let's go ahead and lift off that lid, and we can see all the pieces wrapped in plastic. Let's remove that, and here we go. All of the pieces for Spider-Man Noir will start with the two gargoyles. So you have one on the left, which has these orange highlights because that's the one that is reflecting the inside light. And the one on the right has that blue tinge reflecting the moon and the outside aesthetics. Then we'll move on to his right hand. He's got his grappling hook gun, and you can see those blue highlights on his hand as well and on top of the gun. So even though it's a black and white character, they use these subtle tones to really bring it to life. A lot of detail sculpted into the gun as well. Here we have the other right hand switch out. This is for the exclusive edition. And again, look at the blue tones on top of the black glove. And then you have the spider idol, the relic that's responsible for giving Peter his powers in this universe. Collector's edition portrait, he's got the fedora, he's got the webbed mask with those old school goggles, and again, I gotta compliment the paint job, the orange tinge on the right side of his face, highlighting the inside glow, and then on the left, again, you have some of that blue from the outdoors. Now, the exclusive portrait has a battle damage look, and there's a lot more going on here. Peter's face is exposed. You can see his teeth, you can see his right eye, and then he has his hair poking out the top of the mask. Same great detail with the paint job and even the stitching on that leather mask. It looks amazing. No pun intended. I do think this is cool, but I think that that traditional fedora look is more for me. All right, guys, and then we have the torso. So he is split up into two. He's got a leather trench coat. He's got that turtleneck. Again, with the paint highlights, really bringing this piece to life. 100% sculpted on the trench coat, and he has those belt straps flying loose in the wind. You can see the folds, more of the blue highlights. And then we have the base. So this one is number 64 out of just 400 made for the exclusive. He has his legs and the bottom half of his body attached to this piece of building. You can see the window shattered. You have a piece of the Daily Bugle on the bottom, just adding little Easter eggs to this piece. You have the bricks. And you have Felicia Hardy's White Widow mask as another Easter egg. All right, let's get this on the table here so we can start the assembly. First thing we're gonna do is place that gargoyle in between his legs on the building, the second gargoyle more on the outside, and then we'll carefully put the top part of the torso onto the bottom half, being mindful of the trench coat belt. And then let's do the collector's edition first. So grappling gun in his right hand, and then we'll go ahead and place the portrait there. And I'm really more of a fan of the collector's edition swap outs. I love that fedora. I like that clean look that he has, even though that exclusive portrait has more detail. Let's take a look at that real quick. So spider idol in the right hand, and then battle damage, exclusive portrait. Man, it's very aggressive. I'm digging it. Let's take a look at this piece in full. This one is brought to you by thatspidermanbooth.com. Their February monthly subscription box is live. Not only do you get 5 comics, $100 of retail value for just 50 bucks, but you're going to get 2 additional comics this month. They teamed up with my boy Comic Tom and Fire Guy Ryan for their Crashdown issue number 1, the Gerald Perel variant. The regular, Virgin, and Foil are all limited to 100 copies, and there are only 10 medals. Everyone who subscribes to the box is going to get that regular edition, and then it's going to be a mystery on whether or not you get the virgin, the foil, or the metal. Swing on over to thatspidermanbooth.com and sign up for that subscription box today. All right, guys, and there we go. The Spider-Man Noir premium format by Sideshow. This piece has a lot going on for it, especially for like a lesser-known character. I mean, technically, it is Spider-Man. It is Peter Parker, just from a different universe. What's cool about this character, it's supposed to be black and white, right? But this is a realistic take on that character. You do have those highlights, like I mentioned during the unboxing and the assembly. But even like the window, the glass has a translucency to it. It's kind of like a white going into orange. Then you have, like I mentioned, Felicia Hardy's White Widow mask on the bottom. It's silver. It's got a gash on it, and it does have this orange shine as well. You've got the newspaper there with like the Bugle's description of Spider-Man before they know that he's just a regular person. Well, he's a man with super godlike spider powers. And then you have the broken rubble everywhere, the bricks, adding a little hint of color in this otherwise black and white piece. Now, this one was sculpted by Daniel Bell, which is why it's so impressive. Daniel Bell is a top-tier sculptor. He was joined by partner in crime, George Villar. Richard Long was on the design, Casey Love with the paint. Now, this piece retailed $710 for the exclusive version, which is what you see here, limited to 400 pieces. It's currently waitlisted over on Sideshow, so not sold out yet, but you can't just pre-order it. You can sign up for the waitlist if you absolutely have to have the exclusive, which I don't think is really necessary. This is the collector's edition, what you see here, the fedora portrait, the grappling gun. This one retails $695, and it has an edition size of 600, so there are still some available for the collector's edition. With that grappling gun, it's gonna make the piece a little bit taller than without. You're looking at just above 26 inches tall. Now, as far as the depth, if you're considering the trench coat and the front here of the glass frame, it's about 15 inches in depth. The base itself, though, is more of about 9. And as far as the width, yeah, if you're looking from like the building to the trench coat, once again, about 17.5 inches. However, the base itself is about 10 inches. Extremely impressive piece. The detail in the building, it really reminds me of the OG Spider-Man comic head. It would probably pair really well with that, except for the fact that this one is so much of a newer piece that it would probably make that one look a little bit dated. But I'm loving the base. It's as much the statue as Peter Parker himself, but he really complements it with that trench coat flowing in the wind, giving such natural movement. And you know what's funny? We were recently talking about Sideshow when I was reacting to their new Superman premium format and how they typically go fabric with their capes. That's sculpted, and this is fully sculpted too, because I think in the past you probably would have seen like a fabric trench coat, but it looks like they're getting away from that. It really adds great composition and gives you a nice silhouette of this piece, the way that the building is moving this way and this cape is flowing that way. Now, although I like that collector's edition portrait better, you can't deny the detail that's packed into the exclusive. As a kid, I always remember seeing Spider-Man battle damage. I mean, especially in the 90s, his costume was always getting ripped up, hair coming through the mask, beaten and battered, and this portrait shows this off so well. Plus, you have the Easter egg, the origin of the character in his right hand with that spider idol. Really impressive piece. Let me know what you guys think about it in the comments down below. What did you think of Nick Cage, his portrayal of the character in Into the Spider-Verse? He was one of my favorite characters. What's that line that he had?
Sometimes I let matches burn down to my fingertips just to feel something, anything.
And what do you think about the rumors that he'll play the live-action version in the show? Sound off below. I appreciate you guys watching. And as always, stay minty fresh. Peace.